would have liked to have done all afternoon long.
And, you know, against other teams in the conference, they'll get their chances. This just happens to be one of those teams very well disciplined, and more importantly than not, rarely turn the ball over. West Virginia only one above the season average's turnovers with 11. Normally they only turn it over 10 times a game.
And a 30 taken by Connecticut now with 2:14 left to go.
You know, if they can turn teams over, if they can get out in the open floor, this is what they'll do. And West Virginia again averaging 21 turnovers forced against opponents per game. And, you know, they're capable of getting out there and beating you in transition.
Missouri State and Creighton coming up next. Tip time at 4:05. Be right in time for after this one is done.
Well, I suspect this one's done already. Just a question of letting the time run out.
Well, you got a head coach here, Jim Calhoun, with all that experience. You stuck 15 points with 2 minutes to go. What was that timeout about?
I think that timeout was about, hey, let's try to run our stuff. Let's try to attack. See if we can get to the line. You know, knowing the jump shots aren't falling.
He's going to get another. Well, Scott, 2:09 left to go in this one. And West Virginia is sitting out the upset at number 9, Connecticut, trying to beat them for just the second time in a Big East game between the two teams.
And if you look closely, you'd wonder if John Beilein was winning or losing. Got his team up 15 with 2:09 left. Should be a smile on his face.
You've known coaches for a long time. How many do you know to smile in a situation like this one?
Now you have to wait for the last 10 seconds or so when he knows it's in the bag and that the roof won't cave in or anything like that to take the win away.
Keep fussing at him right to the end. A big step forward game for West Virginia here this afternoon in the Big East opener, and a game that you would imagine that a very young Connecticut team is going to learn a lot from.
Well, again, I'm very impressed with West Virginia, how they just stuck to their game plan. You know, when they needed to, they spread the floor, ran their system. They were able to get out and run in the fast break situation. They attacked the rim when the shot blocker wasn't there, and they penetrated and kicked when he was.
Wiggins on the drive, and the dish, and the foul with 1:35 left to go. We're talking about the unbeatens in the top 25, assuming that this score holds up. UCLA, Oregon, and Clemson, the only undefeated teams remaining.
Oregon and Clemson both have to be huge surprises. You know, Clemson, obviously, they'll start their ACC schedule. Oregon will ultimately have to face UCLA.
That Clemson record should read 13-0. The beat back inside. And back up he goes. He'll go to the free throw line. Final word between those two. It's been kind of an interesting roller coaster ride for Jim Calhoun and Reggie Greenwood here in the second half.
Well, it was Reggie that teed up Jim Calhoun. I think they were probably making nice right there, getting an explanation. Jim Calhoun said, what I was trying to say was.
Most coaches do want that last word. Missouri State and Creighton coming up right after the end of this one. We'll switch you out.
Well, obviously, that's a Hall of Fame coach, and Reggie Greenwood, a veteran, well-respected referee. And, you know, there are times when they disagree, and when Jim disagrees too strongly, Hall of Fame or no Hall of Fame, he's going to get teed up like most coaches out there.
Now the held ball. And it belongs to UConn with 90 seconds left to go. Coaching it right on through to the end.
Well, John Beilein, his roots are in being a high school teacher. So, you know, he's going to continue to teach until that bell rings.
That's the thing. He talks about the type of teacher, you know, that he is. His players talk about it as well. It's a whole instruction process, and it's not something that people would necessarily think about from a college coach.
That's right. He breaks it down so guys fully understand it. You know, you talk about some of the improvement of players. Ruoff Alexander sitting on the bench last year, and now you look at them, they're quality basketball players. As Alexander said, he learned how to play as a freshman. That came through practice and through observation and certainly through teaching.
Hibbert's first win here against Connecticut. One of his players, Wellington Smith, said that they taught like that in the classroom, I'd be all honor roll. Wow. Missouri State has taken a quick 2-0 lead in that ball game against Creighton. We'll switch you right to that one when this one is done.
Well, speaking about the teaching, like John Beilein, you can see it in the players. You know, there are no McDonald's All-Americans out here. There are a lot of good players who don't get as much hype but have a significant basketball IQ, have a willingness and desire to work, and certainly, you know, have an understanding of what their roles are or should be. And you combine all those things, and those are teachable people. And I think that's all he wants, John Beilein. He wants people who you can teach. He wants good passers, and he wants guys who understand the game.
Well, it certainly is a different system than most of these youngsters are used to seeing at the high school level. But they really seem to enjoy and buy into it. Under a minute now left. And Wiggins, who's had himself a good day today, now with 18 points. That's a new career high.
And you see Doug Wiggins will emerge as that catch and shoot guy that an athletic team like UConn with all the penetrators need, because you need that outlet. They close off the middle. Somebody's going to have to make them pay.
I told you about the block shots coming in. Connecticut had been averaging almost 11 per game. Today with just 3.
And that goes back to the point I made earlier. West Virginia intelligently attacking Connecticut. When the shot blocker's in there, they're driving to the basket, forcing him up and then kicking. And when he's not in the game, they're taking it all the way in. Plus, let's face it, this is a different talent level than those that have been on the schedule for UConn, and all of those games that they've played, all 11 games, have been at home. You know, where you get an added bounce.
A lot of high fives. Big day for Butler, who had 16. Big day for just about everybody wearing gold and blue. Dyson drilling the 3. End it down to 10, and certainly Connecticut not quitting on this one. Missouri State a 4-0 lead in the game at Creighton. Once again, we'll get you to that one as soon as we're done here. For UConn, next is South Florida, then that game at LSU, which could have been a December game, turned out to be a January game. They also have a game at Pitt coming up within the first couple of weeks of January.
Well, both of those teams obviously ranked, tough, and those games are on the road. And you talked about it, Scott, that LSU game could have been in December. I think after watching this game, Jim Calhoun's very happy that it's in January. He's got a chance to kind of get his guys a little more experience.
And if you just look at the talent, that's all that's missing is that experience before UConn will be sitting right back up where everybody's used to seeing them.
Again, we're talking about 8 freshmen, 5 sophomores.
Meanwhile, West Virginia's got Villanova next. They had a home game against St. John's before they go on to take on 2 of the top teams in the Big East on the road.
Well, a much more experienced team, but, you know, you look at the surprise of Notre Dame, a team that has really demonstrated they can put points on the board, leading the Big East in scoring. And Marquette, terrific guard play. So that presents some challenges for West Virginia, no doubt about it.
Creighton now a 5-4 lead in that ball game. 3.5 minutes in. And Wiggins following his own shot.
That's what he didn't do earlier in the game at a critical point. He backed away from it and allowed West Virginia to get the rebound.
No traveling violation, and the ball will go back to UConn now with 15 seconds left to go.
Well, see, if you're a team like West Virginia, you have a big lead and you let the other team start making a strong comeback toward the end, even if you win, what you've done is created practice fodder. You know you're going to be working on this tomorrow. End of the game situations against the pressure.
You're not telling me that a coach would say to the young man, all right, so you won, but.
Oh, there'll always be a but.
All right, now, there is none of that coming from the home crowd. A standing ovation from the big crowd. It was a big part of this today. And the upset victory for West Virginia as they knock Connecticut for the ranks of the unbeaten. 81-71, the final score. Coming up next, it's Missouri State versus Creighton. A post-game extra from this game can be found on ESPN News. Now to Dave Revson and Doug Gottlieb with Missouri State. For